28 gauge dual coil 0.3 ohms. I like to live dangerously. Sub-Ohm has the potential to produce a lot of vapor. The wires heat up faster and gets hotter. More vapor equals a stronger nicotine hit. But the resistance is not the only thing that's crucial. We'll look at some builds to understand why. The build on the left is using a 26 gauge wire, and the one on the right is a 28 gauge, which both have a resistance of 0.8 ohms. But as you can see, the thicker 26 gauge requires more wire to get 0.8 ohms, which means it will produce more vapor. That's because there's more surface area to vaporize the e-juice. So what happens if we try to get 0.8 ohms using a 32 gauge wire? The wire is so short to the point where it's not practical. Thin wires are used for the higher ohm builds. But for Sub-Ohm, it's best to use a 28 gauge or thicker wire. I use 20 gauge for most of my builds. Now let's look at a dual coil build. Both are using 28 gauge wires and both have a resistance of 0.8 ohms. But the dual coil requires 4 times more wire to get 0.8 ohms. This is a lot more wire and it will produce a lot more vapor. That's why Sub-Ohm vapers like to use at least 2 coils. I'll explain the details next time. Out of box, air holes are small, so vapers will drill larger holes. The coils get really hot, so this will help with the heat as well. Though with larger holes, the flavor is somewhat diluted because the draw is more airy. So the key to controlling vapor is resistance, wire surface area, and airflow. Extremely low resistances work best with a dripper. With the other atomizers, the e-juice will vaporize faster than the wick can absorb it. Drippers don't have this problem because you drip e-juice onto the coil. The heat from Sub-Ohm will eventually wear out the insulator, the part that separates the positive and ground. If this is damaged, it can create a short. Not to worry though, this part is replaceable. The most important thing to keep in mind is the resistance limit. It's different for every battery, and I found a great chart that you can reference. For example, if you have an AW18650 2000 mAh battery, the lowest safe ohm to run would be 0.3 ohms. If you are new to this, I recommend sticking to the chart. If you go too low, you're basically shorting out the battery, and that is what causes the battery to explode. I'll add a link to this chart with other safety information in the description